Meet me after slashing your wrist, yeah. Or at the end if you so insist on persisting when told to cease and desist with this blasphemous shit.
Hello, Shalev. Well, I'm gone.
Welcome if you're new. Welcome back if you're not. It's been a weird couple of days, yo. It's been my kid's birthday the last couple of days as well. But that's not what's been weird. I'll probably elaborate in another video. But I wanted to cheer myself up. And I was just watching Frankie Boyle. And there was a clip on there that just, bro, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know if there's going to be any words applicable for what we're about to watch. You know it's serious when YouTube offers up a warning when you press it. Maybe inappropriate for some users. Bro, man is growing a willy on his arm. But what's mad is, it looks like a fucking willy. Buckle up.
I wonder if you can help me. I've been waiting for an operation. 6 years I've been stuck with a penis on my arm. Malcolm McDonald, you put a penis on my arm and it's still here. Can you imagine 6 years of your life with a penis swinging on your arm? My life is fucked. I'll cut it off soon. I've had enough.
What a sentence. What a sentence. Can you imagine 6 years of it? Bro, I can't imagine a penis on my arm, let alone 6 years. Oh, you need to see this. Surely this is a bit pornographic, though, even though it's on his arm. Bro, if a man said that to me on the phone, I'd lock off the phone. I'd have to. I can't continue that phone call. I cannot continue that phone call. I don't care if I'm working for 999. I cannot continue that phone call. What do you mean? I don't even want to laugh.
I want this penis off my arm, please.
Malcolm lost his penis 12 years ago. He's one of a handful of men who every year lose or are born without one that's fully formed. This film tells the story of three of them and reveals how their penis shapes the way they feel about being a man. 45-year-old Malcolm has been awaiting potentially life-changing surgery for nearly 6 years. No one has ever spent as long living with a penis on their arm.
I'm an everyday man that does the same thing that every other man does.
I don't play darts. I do art, though. Yeah. I like that.
I don't have a penis. 12 years ago, had a job, nice partner, a man's life, bringing the money in, putting food on the table. Baby comes along, relationship ain't too good. I end up living on the streets. Friend of mine in the garage. Set myself a bed up, sofa and a TV. Got myself away in there. I've done more and more drugs.
It suddenly got really serious. But did you notice... did you notice the garage he was stood next to? I'm pretty certain someone drew a cock and balls right above his head. Unless I've just got cock and balls on the brain now. Yeah. No.
Friend of mine in the garage, set myself a bed up, sofa and a TV. Got myself away in there. I've done more and more drugs. He's paying it.
6 months after becoming homeless, a perianal abscess developed between his buttocks.
Swelled up, so it was a tennis ball, and popped. Fucking hurts. When it healed up, it came back. I'm like, I'm not having no more operations on my bum. I'm going to do abscess, I'll pop it myself. So, then I've got to pick it off, put it on my front, and get a needle and pop it.
Malcolm's DIY treatment eventually led to blood.
Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. He was fucking homeless and he's doing medical treatment on himself. It's already a cyst. What the fuck? How did he not die at that moment? That's just like grabbing a ball of infection and then just sticking it into an infection. Oh, poor dude, man. Go to the hospital, bro. You shouldn't be popping abscess things anyway. But definitely don't do it if you're dirty. Fucking hell.
Poisoning.
Your fingers start going black, your toes start going black. Penis still went black. You went to the toilet and you fell off.
Yo! Yo, what the? Fucking. Fuck. Whoa! What the fuck do you mean? What? What the fuck do you mean? What the fuck do you mean it just fell off, bro? What the fuck? Yo! Oh, like my rabbit. He's hilarious. He doesn't know he hasn't got one. I remember the first time he tried fucking after. I remember he was doing it right in front of me and Piper, my old rabbit, bless her, rest in peace. She give it up right in front of me. And it's like, wow, this is like a bit uncomfortable. But he tried, he couldn't. And I knew he couldn't because he... But then like she like gave up, just looked back at him. And walked off. And he sat there for a minute, and it was the most surreal moment. It was the most surreal moment. He sat up, and then he kind of looked down, and I don't know if I was just adding human emotion to the moment, but he sat up, and then he kind of looked down at his thing as if to say, what the fuck's going on? Oh. Poor guy. He still tries. Every now and again he gets in a mood and that. But Cookie's funny. She does it back every now and again. She just starts humping his head. And he just lies there so confused. The old man's woolly just fell off. But I didn't eat, bro, once your thing started...
Your penis fell off.
Go on. See ya.
Eventually, led to blood poisoning.
Your penis started going black, your toes started going black. Penis still went black. You went to the toilet and you fell off.
Your penis fell off.
Gone.
Gone? What do you mean gone? You didn't flush the chain.
Malcolm made it to hospital in time for doctors to save his life. But his penis was gone for good.
Basically, I'm left with a stump.
It must have fell off.
To start weighing.
It's horrible.
Can you remember what it was like to have one?
Not really.
If you're missing male genitalia, there's a solution that's never been more in demand. Phalloplasty. In an intricate operation, surgeons take skin, usually from the arm, to create a new penis and transplant it to the groin.
Right, this is the clip that was on Frankie Boyle. Bro, I know you're picturing, they just said skin. So you're picturing just the tube, innit? Nope. It looks like a penis. Just brace yourself. Fucking brace yourself.
It's my new penis. Good, innit, what I can do.
Malcolm's look how fat it is!
Its final destination. While Malcolm lost his penis in later life, for some men, their challenges begin at birth.
Did I get it?
And you missed.
It's so hard when the ball is so small.
Anik was born with an underdeveloped penis caused by a rare genetic intersex condition called partial androgen insensitivity syndrome.
Oh, this is so racist. Chibadi G. Chibadi G. People just do that. He was born with a micropenis. I mean, his friend was born with a micropenis. They thought he was a girl for the first 6 months. If you've never watched People Just Do Nothing, you have to watch it. It's hilarious. It's so real. It's so real.
Anik has XY chromosomes, but in the womb, his body was unable to respond to male sex hormones in the typical way, and his genitals didn't fully develop. Anik's parents, Sonny and Barty, moved to the UK from Tanzania in the 1980s.
I thought he got married.
Anik was born premature, less than 2 pounds. Nothing was fully grown. He looked like a chicken.
The doctors couldn't tell straight away whether I was a boy or a girl.
The penis was...
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. We need to find this clip. That's exactly what he says. That is exactly what he says.
You must be so excited, mate. You're about to have a little brother.
Sister.
Don't be too short, mate, okay? I had a friend once who was unfortunately born with a micropenis. And, you know, for months, they thought he was a girl.
What?
Anyway, I'll better shoot off in here. I've got stuff to do. See you in a bit, yeah?
Hopefully I put the clip in. Oh my God, that's so funny. That is so funny. Oh my God. He says that. I swear verbatim he says that. That's hilarious. Sorry, dude, I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing at the fact your buddy G said the same shit. Sorry, bro. Sorry. I'm sure you've come to terms with it right now, but I'm not mocking you, bro. I feel for you. Sorry, bro.
Really little.
I've had so many different diagnoses over the years. First, they said it was a buried penis, then a micro penis. It literally hadn't changed much since I was a child. A micro penis. It literally hadn't changed much since I was a child.
Just under 4 years ago, he decided to have phalloplasty.
The idea of getting phalloplasty is just something most people think is science fiction. It's a three-stage procedure where they take skin from one place, they turn it into a tube, and then create a penis from it. The head of the original penis is actually at the bottom. They removed the foreskin completely and then put the new phallus on top of it.
It's the day of Anik's operation.
It's been most of my childhood having these kinds of surgeries. It's kind of like a dick MOT. It's time for a new one.
Surgeons will look to fix the pump and relieve his pain.
I pitch the baggiest trousers. If I have to keep it erect, then it's just easier. I don't feel like I can be excited yet.
I don't feel
you
like
just
you
don't know
be
what you're
going to
wake up
bro.
With. If you're going to have more pain or less pain.
It's time for Anik to start using the pump himself. He'll need to keep his penis erect for at least 30 minutes to allow the skin to stretch.
It's not as hard as it should be. But it's definitely done something. It doesn't stay down anymore. Maybe that means it's done? There we go. A very big difference.
Hiya.
Hi. I just pumped it up.
Oh, how are you feeling?
Pretty good.
Oh my gosh, that looks so much real.
Mm.
How painful was it?
yeah? Well, a bit because I slipped, but I'm going to have to see what it's like when I push it down again.
Okay. Speak to you soon.
Bye.
To deflate it, you need to locate the release valve. But it takes some practice.
Ow. Fuck. Ow. Okay, I've done it. There we go.
I don't know what the fuck's going on in the world no more. Right, so I hope they explain, can he just keep a boner as long as he want? Or is this just training? Or is, fuck's sake. You know, it's 6:54 in the morning, you know. I haven't woken up to this, I haven't been asleep yet. Fuck's sake.
A successful phalloplasty can transform lives.
Thank you very much, yeah.
Care home manager Lee was born without a penis.
What's a man without his penis? How can he feel like a man if he hasn't got that part?
He currently lives alone and has spent most of his adult life unlucky in love.
Relationships didn't work out because that part was missing. One girlfriend that woke up one morning, turned around and said, Lee, I need a penis. That hurt me bad. That really hurt. Nature's not always perfect. Things do go wrong.
He grew up in North London, the eldest of three children.
There's a picture there with my younger brother. I must have been 10 or 11 years old there.
Who's that little girl on the bottom right?
That's me. When I was four or five years old. I don't see a little girl in my mind. I see a boy. Name is Lisa. I knew I needed a penis from as young as 6 or 7. It had to be corrected so I could be fulfilled and happy and whole.
Bro, where is this episode? I wanted to see more of the other man because in the clip, he was cooking. And he says, it keeps burning it. It keeps burning. Anyway, next time, though.